Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Urban Design on City Skylines with me, Praised. Now, we are doing episode 8, the long-awaited episode 8. Since episode 7, there's actually been a lot of progress being done. And I apologize for the long wait for between episodes. I would have definitely had a lot more episodes done, like probably we'd be up to episode probably 14 by now, if not for me doing a bit of Twitch streaming. And I've been doing a lot of live streaming, actually, and so it's actually ended up allowing us to get even further ahead than what we would normally by just making episodes. So as you can see, this whole area is quite different from episode 7, and that's because we've extended the lake that we had around over here. We've extended a few neighborhoods. We still haven't necessarily fixed all our issues here with our bus lines, because we just haven't had the time to do that. We were expanding and not actually fixing things up. But all the new lines that we have been doing and building, they actually have been done pretty much just like you guys have been actually asking for, which is create lines on similar paths and more simplified paths that actually take a much easier route through the neighborhoods. And both do anti-clockwise and clockwise directions. Now, this isn't the only thing that we've actually been working on right here. So what I did actually is, this recording right now is just pretty much right after the stream of the stream that happened today. And so what I've done is some pre-planning of extra neighborhoods where we can actually put our further development of this city, so we can where we can connect the suburbs. We've also connected a new highway, which is kind of not together. They don't run parallel with one another. They actually run slightly off, and then they join up later along the line. So we'll be squeezing in some neighborhoods in between over here as well. And the St. Kilda Beach area has not actually been developed at all. I'm still deciding on what needs to be done here and there. But we've been focusing on other areas, and I will show you right now. So if you haven't been following the Twitch streams, this will come as a complete surprise for you. As you can see, look at all this work. Now, this has actually taken me quite a lot of time. It's about, since last week, so this is taken me about a solid week's worth of work, with about 3 or 4 Twitch sessions in between. And so what we've done is expanded our farming industry right here. And with our farm industry, we've got 3 or 4 little towns. No, actually, we've got 5 little towns. Millbrook, Beavermead, Alina, I think, Riverside, and something else. Let's just have a quick look. It's I thought I actually had named it, but I haven't. This was going to be another name over here, Redbrook or something. Oh no, I did. It's just not showing up. Redwood Park, there it is, Redwood Park. So it is showing up now. So we've essentially created little towns within High Court Hills, which is the name of the whole industrial area with all the farms. We've downloaded a few mods, and all the mods you can actually download from the link below. I've got like the link to my Steam Workshop, which I've shared all the mods that I'm actually using for this city alone, so you guys can share the same mods. So I use some of these mods to like color in some of the fields in the actual farming industry. It's just a simple coloring thing, which comes in different block sizes, and you just place it down. So yeah, it just gives that slightly more realistic look with these farms around over here. Now we got Millbrook, Beavermead, Alina, Riverside, and over here we've got Eucalyptus Grove. And Eucalyptus Grove is our forestry industry, connected right here next to our farming industry. There's still a few areas here and there that need to be filled out with like detailing, trees, little wooden fences. But we've got our first kind of main proper cargo train terminal all here and set up. So we're not having too many difficulty. We had a few issues here and there where we had a lot of traffic coming in and out, but we've kind of resolved that issue with a few little modifications during those Twitch streams. But everything seems to be functioning very well and quickly. And so we're not having any problems where stock is not getting out fast enough or things not being replenished fast enough. So these little towns such as Riverside, they don't offer much except for just a few little basic housing, maybe an elementary school or two, and just the bare essential things that you would find in like little towns like this on the outskirts of the main city. Edina, on the other hand, has got quite a large factory here. It's called the Metsa factory, and it also produces quite a lot of electricity. This one at the moment is only producing 77 megawatts, but it's a nice little addition into the actual just landscape around this area. So, and I've got another building that I've actually downloaded, and it's right over here. It's actually the Colossal Mills building, and I'm by seeing that I think it's got a little cereal bowl in it, so I think it actually is a cereal factory. There you go. It actually has cereal factory written all over it. So, the Chirpy Crisps. So I've added this in, and because of the Colossal Mills, the Mills part, this ended up being Millbrook. We had quite a few traffic problems around here, but it's kind of sorted itself out. We still do from time to time, but they're only very small, and it's not stagnant traffic. The traffic is still constantly moving, so it's not an issue for us. We added a lot of wind turbines as well, just for the realism's sake, just to make it look like farmlands as well. Over here between Beavermead and Millbrook, we actually added a bike path. I'm not really too fond of it, and I don't think it's really getting used at all. But it's here just for the design aesthetic, and over here I did a bit of design garden work called HCH, so that stands for the High Court Hills over here. So just a little nice little design aesthetic for the city. And that's about it for this area. So this area really did take us quite a long time. I also, half of the actual area also got kind of deleted because I didn't save by accident one night, so I had to kind of redo everything a little bit. But now that we are here and actually recording, I'm thinking what we can do is perhaps start expanding on another little town that we've been working on, or a little neighborhood suburb. And this one will actually start working on Colima. So Dillondale, Sumil, Colima, Nuevo Velez. That's actually, someone suggested that on the Twitch stream to continue that, as if the new Velas from Santa Arcangelo should still exist. Isaria, Old Colorado, Ajax, and Redstone. So we've got quite a few new names and potential suburbs in already. Guys, you don't have to suggest any more suburbs. I've got, my list is completely full, and I'm struggling as it is enough to keep putting in more names, because the rates that we're expanding our suburbs just does not meet the rate at which you guys are offering me new suburb names. So I thank you for that. So I think we're good for suburb names now. I think we should have enough to fill the entire map. If not, I'll let you guys know when we will start filling that in again. I did also, since last episode, I did do a lot of reworking on this bridge. And so I had little issues where the actual decoration of this bridge was not even with the other side. So what I did was pretty much leveled out the ground and then started placing the highways on through it. And now the highways are perfectly straight. Absolutely perfectly straight running through it. So, and I started adding these pedestrian footpaths on either side as well over here. So they added a nice little touch of lighting on the side. And it really does look like the actual bridge is now properly connected with the suspension cables. I haven't done the other side yet, but that's still yet to be done. So we'll get to that as soon as possible. One thing though that bothers me is every time I load the map, I get these... on the pedestrian footpaths, I get these poles running down, and I do place these pedestrian paths with the floating tool, so it doesn't create any poles. But for some reason they keep reappearing whenever I reload the game. So it's not a major concern, but it's something that you can always fix if you need to, but I'm not going to be fixing that every single episode or every single time I jump on. So don't worry about that. We can always take that off any time, but it's there for now until we can find a proper solution. Now, I've also inversed the way the highways actually connect over here. I had the top ramp actually going, joining up to the right highway over here, and the bottom highway underneath going to the left. I've switched those around because they just create a much smoother transition now between all these highways. So, and just the general access point onto this bridge. So, and this bridge is actually getting used quite a lot, so it's really good to see. We're not getting errors on the bridge as well, and at night the bridge looks absolutely stunning because I did do add my own custom lighting, so as you guys have probably seen in previous episodes. Okay, so over here now, let's see, what can we do? So we've connected this new highway around over here with a temporary, don't worry about this connection with all these highways, that's not going to stay like that. That's all just purely temporary work so that we can actually have the extra support for the actual highway which we have running over here, because this highway was starting to get a little bit full here and there. So I decided to give the extra support of building extra highways around up over here on top of the hills. So yeah, this episode, I guess, because we have a bit of low demand for residential, we'll work on doing a small neighborhood over here in Colima. Now, just before we do want to start, I just want to see what we've done. As you can see, with our public transport lines, our lines have been simplified much easier. So, for example, if we go into Kena, you can see Akina line number 97 ACL and line number 97 CL. So anti-clockwise and clockwise, and they both have the same number now. So I'm starting to get the process of fixing the bus lines and making them more simplistic, and just naming them properly as well. So they're all exactly the same lines. The first four neighborhoods that we did, Rafa, Elwood, Taranaki, Rochester, they all still have to be done. So but the new suburbs have got basic lines introduced into them. So we're getting there. Slowly, step by step, we are getting there. So just have to give it some more time. And we will have everything done. Okay, so I'm just taking into consideration, though, of everything that we have over here and where we can potentially expand to, because we've got Colima over here. And what I want to make sure is that we can potentially connect a bus line, and we can because the metro station is right here on the edge, on the corner of this intersection. So we'll get some buses coming around to this and going through Colima. So let's get this show underway then, eh? Now we won't spend too much time. Oh, I still haven't zoned out all these areas properly, like the first few neighborhoods. These neighborhoods have just been pretty much just put in place just to get the names in, but once we actually start fully initializing all these areas and start charging extra taxes because of all the proper services being offered, we'll actually start also fixing up these neighborhoods with the proper painting district tool. So this is a very small neighborhood, Colima, so this shouldn't take long. I don't want to spend too long on this episode, because I don't have the time on me right now, but because we ended up spending all day streaming. So let's try and get this done as fast as possible. So I'll just be doing a little bit of a process that we've been doing throughout the streams, and that's just expanding the neighborhoods in a nice little unique way. And that's by adding lots of the cul-de-sacs, which we've been doing previously as well. It's just want to see what we can do. And you guys can always, don't forget to comment. If you guys, like for instance, don't know how to do this yellow line, I can always say leave a comment and let you guys know. It's always been, I think, mentioned. It's one of the hot topics, I think, of how do you get the yellow lines to show as a guide when you're connecting these roads together. So don't be shy to ask away, because I can definitely help you out with that. Okay, so I think that's the basic Colima structure that I'm going to have, just like that. We don't need anything too much, anything too crazy. We'll add a few shops here and there. And once we add all this residential in, I think Colima will be able to start developing nicely. And we'll add a few commercial shops, and we can work on another area as well. We can work on Piccadilly, because Piccadilly is going to be based on only commercial zone, so it's like a bit of a generic central commercial zone for all these located neighborhoods around over here. We've also expanded Brighton over here, I think, yes. So Brighton is around over here on the inside of the entry point into the bay. One thing that we also did was Sunrise Beach. Now, this had a lot of discussions, people saying, we've got that little touristy area over here in St. Kilda for all the tourists to utilize the beach and all that. And over here at Sunrise Beach, we've got that this should be more of a quieter beach, more for the actual residents to enjoy. And so I didn't add any large hotels. I only added like a small district, small amount of commercializations, and they're all mainly to do with leisure. And it seems to be working quite well. We added some nice palms. I still have to go into the workshop though and download like some assets, like sunbathing lounges and maybe like little shops that you can actually just uniquely place without actually snapping onto anything, to any road guides or anything like that, so that we can actually make these beaches look like, you know, they're real beaches and not just a big white piece of sand that's just open. So that's something that we will have to do. Now let's see how Colima is expanding, because we do have the demand. I'm just going to increase the speed so that we can get some actual faster progress done this episode. Okay, now when the next episode, you may be asking, will be coming out. Now I'm not too sure. It's Thursday right now, so I'll probably be trying to release this, this will be released most likely on, you'll be watching this and it will be Friday, so when the next episode will come out, I'm not too entirely sure. If it doesn't come out on Monday, if I'm not recording on Monday, then I'm most likely streaming. However, and I don't think I will be doing any recording over the weekend, because I've got prior commitments. But what I will try and do is actually cut down the streams a little bit for you guys, or even do like a pre-recording before I do a stream, so that actually I do have some content. But because we've done so much work off camera or off YouTube, I've decided that, you know, after this massive stream that we did over the last week, all the massive streams that we've done, that I'll include a video to do a big update and roundup of what you guys have been missing that perhaps have not had the chance to jump onto Twitch. So yeah, let's see, we've got more detailing to do around over here, perhaps some more park connections, I think. So if I were to jump into the road tools, I'm going to add a pedestrian crossing around over here. Let's jump this across this road over here. This actually could have worked as a nice cul-de-sac. That's going to change now. No. That's going to change, because I've just figured out that I can place a very nice, right here, centralized cul-de-sac. Like that. And that will just give us some better usage out of the space over here. And now, potentially, what I'm going to do is add another couple more parks. I'll add this park over here. I love these parks because they get all lit up during the night. And let's actually jump into options and turn our day and night cycle on, because we're close to the suburbs. So we still will be able to actually see things that are going on. And over here, let's just see. All this can be filled up with residential. We're not going to be doing any exit paths around over here, except for here. We can close that off. Let's get some footpaths. So this footpath can come around to, say, over here. And now this footpath can come around to here. There we go. And that's all going to be closed off, so that's fine. We'll just keep adding trees around over here. And it should look quite okay. This area. And we'll add it with pine trees and everything. So it shouldn't be a problem to make this whole area look pretty sweet. I'll zone all this up. Let's zone all this up. Let's just get all this zoning done so that we can actually progress a little bit faster. I'll add a commercial shop over here without the paint bucket, please. The paint bucket tool is not what I want to use. Let's chuck that across over here. And we'll chuck a straight line like that. And we'll add some more shops around over here because I think we might be in need of some. Now in Columa, we might add a few high density buildings as well. So let's see, that's 4x4, 4x4. Alright, so we'll just do everything and we'll fill in the rest. With a few parks and a few trees like that. We'll get the big pine tree in. So it's all filling in very nicely. And we'll start adding some bus lines in as well. So we'll go to Metro Line over here. So the next thing is just to decide where this bus line will go through. Okay, so first stop will be over here on this intersection, or just before the intersection. Because we don't want to push it too close to the intersection, because from the right lane, jumping onto the left lane to turn left can be a bit of a hassle for the buses. We don't want that. Right, so the next stop will be over here. We'll make the buses come through over here. And we'll just go through the center of Columa, I reckon. I think that will do the job. Nice and simple bus lane. And then we'll do an anti-clockwise as well. But the anti-clockwise can perhaps... let's see, if we go in anti-clockwise direction... We could, and yeah. We'll do an anti-clockwise directional bus, which goes in the same direction pretty much. Stops over here, same like little stops. It's nice and basic, it pretty much covers everything. All these people are all getting affected, so it doesn't matter if we don't cover all the streets. Okay, so now, because of those true lines that we've added, I'm just going to figure out a color that we can use. Perhaps a... what's sky blue? We could do with a nice fluoro sky blue. Aqua blue, aquamarine, I don't know. Okay, and we'll do the same with this. Not so green. There we go. Perfect, so bus line this one. So call this Columa line, and I'll just make up a number called 72. And this one is clockwise or anti-clockwise, I don't remember. I'll call it CL for now, and we'll find out. And it's anti-clockwise, so we'll have to fix that up. Anti-clockwise, there we go. And the next one, simple enough, just do exactly the same. Columa, line 72, clockwise. There we go. And it'll be just much easier when the lines are exactly the same number because they're doing the same route, the same color. And this shall eventually, most likely, hopefully service our metro station very well. Now, if we actually just jump into here, we can already see that there's people waiting. So this is good. Because as you guys are all very well aware, the way I've been building the suburbs is the lines have been just serving the small little neighborhoods. And then they essentially go to the main hub of some sort of a metro station. And then the metro station does all the work of them transporting customers or the commuters around the city. Because it's much more effective and efficient. Alright, so now that we've built our public transport line, oh, it's nighttime. I haven't seen nighttime in a while, actually, because we've been streaming all the time in the day. So there you go. Here's our beautiful bridge. There you go. And all our nice little neighborhoods around here. They're all just joining up very nicely. As you can see. And these are all future neighborhoods around over here. They're all completely black, but as you can see, once they're filled up, they will all look exactly the same. Or not exactly the same, but in their own little unique way. and the highways are all nicely being connected, and this is what I love. Look at the farmlands. Farmlands do look really pretty. It's dark, but you can clearly see where the little towns are in and amongst all the little farming industry, and you can see where the main roads through the farming area are currently going, and all the little big black spots in between all the main roads are like the little smaller roads with that have not been lit up, and they have like all the little farms and all that in between. Now over here we've got a few problems. Yeah, we've got a few fires out of control in our eucalyptus grove area with our forestry industry is, but that's going to be taken care of, no problem. So there's something I really like in this area is the actual highway. It just flows so well. It's not perfectly straight, it has quite a lot of curves, different directions, and it just cuts through quite naturally through the actual area. Now let's just quickly head over to the neighborhood. Let's watch this sunrise, because it really is quite beautiful when it just jumps over the top over here. Or even let's just jump back over here over the farmlands, just watch the sunrise take over and everything will start switching off. Even if we can just get a slightly better overview that includes even like the city or the neighborhoods, all the lights start switching off naturally. It's quite nice. I really like the way that Colossal Orders implemented the switching of the lights on and off. It's very quite natural. Not everything just turns off and on. Everything has a certain stage. So this is good. Okay, so next thing on our list to do is Colma has pretty much finished now, hasn't it? How are our hospital service? Fine. Fire services are fine around over here. And our police services are also fine. So that's good. Education though. Education can be definitely improved upon. So I'm thinking we could add perhaps like a elementary school right there. We've got very good coverage for elementary. We're lacking on the high school part of things at the moment, but we'll fix that up because it's usually just the outer suburbs over here of the new suburbs that we've been developing. But they'll start filling out once we start filling in like Nueva Velez, Isaria, Old Colorado, AX Redstone, Somali, and Dillondale. So once we actually start working on the next suburbs out here, we'll start adding more high schools, which will increase the capacity, and because I don't want to place high schools too close to one another. I still want some relatively good coverage, but something that will still reach our capacity to go over our actual eligibility. Okay, so Colima is now pretty much completed. What I'm going to do is just to start some fillers. Now, we do this quite a lot, and you won't believe the farmlands that we were doing on stream. I did it also kind of for a reason, because there was a lot of this, placing trees one by one, not doing the whole brush tool. It's because there was a lot of borders to split up all the farms from one another. And if you guys are actually interested, like, to have more details of how I built those farms, I'm more than happy to do like a quick recap and just to show you of how I did it. But that's one of the main reasons why I was doing it on Twitch, because the last thing I wanted to be doing on YouTube is releasing videos where I'm doing nothing but planting trees. And even in a time lapse, I mean, I think I can do better than just show you videos of how to plant trees. So, but look, in future episodes, I can definitely actually show you guys how I did build those farm areas. Now, if you are actually curious, I do have the Twitch channel linked below, so you guys can check that out. That has quite a few videos of all the action that you may have been waiting for and missed during the entire week. So if you have the time, I was playing some music, live music, when I was actually recording as well, so you might have a few areas that have been muted, so you might not be able to hear, due to all those stupid copyright infringements and all that. So, but other than that, I think if you want to catch up, that's probably your best place to, if you've missed any action over the week. In this episode, I've tried to recap everything that I can possibly do. There's been a lot of work on these farms, so, and yeah, just in general, there's a lot of names out here which weren't on the list before, but now, due to those Twitch streams, have made their way in. Brighton is still also another neighbourhood that I'm going to have to work on in terms of filling in detail, so we might be able to do that this episode, actually, because it's still not going way over time or anything like that. So let's see, if I push over here in Piccadilly, what I'm thinking is we can do, this is supposed to be like a commercial zone, and being a commercial zone and having these awkward shapes, I want to make sure that I can still utilize the space fairly well. So first things first, what I'm thinking is I'm going to have to add like a park. It's always my go-to thing, add a park. There we go. And from a park, we can always work off that. So let's see. If we were to create a road which cuts across in this direction like that. Or can we actually... I actually haven't got anything connected at a 90 degree angle with this park. Do I know? So this is going to have to be kind of on the fly like that. If I just join that up like that. And from here, let's see. We can create a road which goes in this direction. Now, it doesn't matter if we're so close to the highway, because these are going to be commercial shops anyway. So... oh, that hasn't been fixed. That's the wrong one. I actually modified this park to not have the gravel paths, but actually like concrete paths. So the concrete paths actually come with like a lighting system. So the actual parks are now lit up properly, and all the paths, interconnecting paths, those paths as well, are connected properly and all lit up. So it actually looks pretty decent. Now around over here, let's see. Thinking we might have to add a couple of segments of road that are curved 5x5 over here. This can come out to here, that can join up here, and perhaps this road should be able to connect up like that directly across. And now from here we can also push a line or a road that goes directly across here like that. That's not really straight, is it? That didn't turn out as well as I had hoped. So if I push that out to here, this out to there, hopefully it's not perfect, but it will do the job of connecting something nicely like that. And in between all these areas, we can start filling in. I mean, Piccadilly, right now, looking at it, it would definitely work much better as a residential zone, wouldn't it? Just by looking at it like this. So, what I'm thinking is, we're going to change it up. We're going to make commercial on the outskirts on this main avenue, because we've got the commercial zones on the outskirts on the other side of this neighborhood. We'll add a couple small shops. And on the inside, we'll add our residential demand, because we still have demand for residents, so we may as well. We'll fit in quite a bit better, I think. Now just have to make sure that we can connect these paths before we actually completely zone this area off. So I'll just make a little connection like that. No, that's not right, because it takes away a bit of our precious building space. So let's see if we can push this out to here and just join it up like that. That's fine. And we got lighting systems as well. So that's good. Remove that. Let's see if we can just build a path out to here and now just join this up like this underneath the highway and then join up over here. Perhaps we can also connect a footpath around over here and a footpath over here. So what we're trying to do is get some more interconnectivity between the parks with the avenues, because the avenues usually have the bus lines running through them. And over here, we'll just, no, remove that. That didn't clip on properly. Clip that onto there. And now with that done, we'll start zoning. Just like that. Nice and easy. And hopefully this will all turn out to be pretty nice. On the outside over here, ooh, this could be all commercial shops. We'll do that as commercial shops. Just remove that block right there. We'll start adding details in between as well. Okay, and also in between all that work that we're doing on Twitch, we've actually unlocked the Megalopolis achievement. So we've actually reached a fit population of 50,000. So we've unlocked everything. We've got the international airport unlocked and everything else. So now all it is just about landmarks, unlocking landmarks and unlocking monuments as well. Oh, and over here, something that I didn't realize is what we can build towards our Eden project. So what do we need? Business park, cathedral, neighborhood park, official park, construct servicing services offices. Okay, and so that's a lot that we need to do, and construct statue of industry. So there's quite a few things for the Eden project, but that's something I'm definitely want to work towards. So we'll see how we go with that. All right, so now that we have some daytime, we'll be able to start filling in the details inside Piccadilly, and even perhaps start focusing on a bus line, because we've got a metro station right over here and it's always busy. But I'm gonna have to figure out a way how to get Piccadilly to connect to this station. So the Piccadilly line is gonna be very simplistic. It's gonna have to go through Parkdale perhaps, and even because we can't really, or into Elwood. I'm not too sure. We haven't actually got a bus line going through Parkdale yet, so Parkdale is something that we're gonna have to work on as well. So while we're here, let's do this. We can do two simple lines. We'll do a clockwise line. Do a stop over here, stop over here, stop over here, stop over here. This is gonna be the first Parkdale line. Out to here, here, and here. Okay, so that's the first Parkdale line done. Next Parkdale line. Okay, so stop here, here, actually no, we can stop just around over here, here, stop there, then join up with this line, and come back. Okay, so Parkdale is covered. It's been very nice, quick and basic. Let's go, Parkdale, line. Let's say random number 63. Okay, and that's anti. I did the. What line are we modifying? Clockwise, I think. No, anti-clockwise. So let's see. Also, I have to modify the line. Which color is it? Okay, so it is actually the clockwise direction. Oops, my bad. And we'll just change the color. What color do we not have around here? We'll use the same color like we used previously, like that, but it's slightly off. Okay, now this color as well, very similar, and this one is going to be Parkdale line 63, I think it was. And this one's ACL for anti-clockwise. Perfect. So let's just drive here. Yep, all good. So Parkdale is done. Now the work for Piccadilly. Now Piccadilly is going to have a stop round, say, on the inside over here when you enter. One over here. One over here. That should pretty much cover everyone. Yeah, it does cover everyone very well. Out to here. Out to here, then we'll stop near the beach area, stop over here where Parkdale line is currently going, stop over here, then at the metro stop, and then over here. It's quite a long line, but it covers it, covers everything pretty well. So this is going to be Piccadilly line, say 81. I'm just generating random numbers in my head, whatever. And this is anti-clockwise as well. And we'll just change the color to say something red. Where's the Piccadilly line? Here. and I'll change it to something red like that. Okay, that's fine. Now the next new line, this is gonna have to be the anti-clockwise. Okay, no, this is gonna be the clockwise now. So what I'm gonna do, the clockwise one, we'll have a slight variant inside of Piccadilly itself. Stop here, stop here, then to the metro station, and then to the bus stop on the avenues, one over here. There's quite a few stops on these avenues. Another one over here, and then none over here. We could definitely add one over here somewhere like that, and then add one over here. There we go. So what line was Piccadilly actually? I've already forgotten. It was line 81. So let's jump into the red color, something the same, slightly more red, juicier red. Okay, Piccadilly, line 81, and this one is anti-clockwise, I think. No, clockwise. There we go. Perfect. That's it. Beautiful. And so we still have a few names to fix up and all that, but it's, other than that, it's going pretty smoothly. We can add our trees. Okay. Can add these trays, just make the parks just gel a little bit better. It makes it all look as if, like, these solitary parks usually on their own are a bit bland, so by adding all these trays and like extra walkways, it really just spice things up by like making these parks look like they're actually a lot, there's more to them than what you can actually see. So there we go. Now over here, we'll add our soundproofing. We haven't said that in a long time, have we? Soundproofing the highway from these areas. Okay. And we'll add a few pine trees here and there, just to break things up. There we go, there we go, there we go, there we go. Okay, that's all really nice. Now I'm thinking around in this area we can also add some commercial buildings inside this lake that came with the game, like the specialization. So I was thinking perhaps like a restaurant would be nice to add right near this bus stop too. That would be nice. That'd be pretty unique. If we can just get it to clip, that is. If we can get it to clip. Now that doesn't look too bad. Now this restaurant has got a Spanish flag on top. Cool, so they come with different kind of flags on the top. That's pretty cool, I didn't realize that. Well, that adds like a nice little touch. It's like a little restaurant inside this lake, which is actually rather massive. Very, very big lake. So Piccadilly is now pretty much completed. How are you going for education? Elementary is pretty much non-existent, and in Parkdale as well, non-existent. So let's just add an elementary school around over here, if we can, somewhere. Because we need something to cover Parkdale and Piccadilly. So what if we put into Parkdale? That should cover most areas. Well, somewhere on this avenue. No, that doesn't cover enough of Parkdale then. If we place it there, that does cover Piccadilly and Parkdale. So we'll place an elementary school here. Let's see. We don't have any high schools in this area, so we'll add a high school. It's definitely something that's required. So we'll add a high school over here into Brighton. And everyone should start getting really happy. And it will also help us with our limits of our capacity, because we're currently under capacity for how many eligible compared to how many students we can actually really have. So that will help with that. if I show you the actual stats somewhere, if we can find them. Let's see, where are the stats? Where are the stats? School. Education, here. So high school, as you can see, we're up to 7,000, but we've got 8,800 eligible, so we definitely need to increase that. Okay, so I'm going to add some more trees over here into this part of Brighton. I'm not going to go all the way next to the highway because I still have future plans for future renovations and just modifications that have to be done to the bridge itself. So I'll be leaving that alone. And yes, we can add a few more trees around over here near these parks. And this area in Brighton as well, just a few trees, just random spamming in between buildings. There we go. Okay, we'll get a few pine trees. There we go. Lovely. Pine tree here, pine tree there. Pine trees everywhere. But not going over the top. Pine tree over here. Pine tree over there. If we can get it to snap, there it is. Okay, here, there. Alright, beautiful. So at least kind of Brighton now is looking a little bit more homely for the residents around in this neighborhood. Can we squeeze in a few trees in between over here like that? So it is looking rather plain, these little blocks around over here. That there, it just disappeared. There we go. Maybe add a tree around over here near the entrance points of the residential properties. That could definitely add a lot more detail. It's just these little touches that add so much extra character to your town. As you can see, that little block now looks so much better with a few extra trees. Okay. So, Brighton is done. We've finished it off with all the extra little decorations and trees. We could actually do with a few more trees over here like that. Because we've got palm trees near the beach, where we've got our little yacht rental. Oh, sorry. Hold on. Let's just... Oh, it's not putting in. It's not jumping in. No. Can't place it in. There we go. Okay. We'll place something else over here and over here like that. There we go. No, it keeps disappearing. Oh, well. Anyway, we've got a few palm trees over here near the jet ski rental and the marina. And on the beach we don't actually have anything, so yeah, that's Brighton. I've added a soccer field over here as well, just to add some extra different kind of buildings and facilities around to these residential areas. And now what I'm thinking is, because we're struggling a bit with income in Brighton, I'm actually going to start charging them extra taxes, because they have all the services they need. They've got they don't have bus services yet, so that's something that we have to still introduce. But bus services will be introduced eventually, but they've got all the educational services they need, so, and they've got all the beautifications and all the parks and recreation, so we can charge them more. But while we're here also in Brighton, I'm also going to add that policy of high-rise ban and heavy traffic ban, because we don't want that happening here. Parkdale as well. Policies, straight in. Taxation for commercial and low density commercial and residential, high rise ban and heavy traffic ban, because we don't want heavy traffic and we don't want tall buildings. Piccadilly is exactly the same, so we'll just do that. And all the neighborhoods, all these external neighborhoods are all running exactly the same, so hopefully we'll see our income go up a little bit. Corto, let's see. Corto has got pretty much everything. It's got buses, bus services. It's got education. I don't see why we should not start charging Corto extra taxes. Let's do the heavy traffic ban and There we go. Let's start charging them extra taxes because they're living in a very comfortable city with all the services available to them, so I don't see why we shouldn't. Okay, shower. We've been working on a shower, so I'm going to fix the shower. So we'll fix out the residential zones and we'll do this as the last thing on this episode. So because I want to just start charging these four districts right here, what I'm going to do is just zone these districts out like this. And so once they're all zoned out, we'll be able to start charging all the appropriate people the right taxes. There we go. So that's done. Akina now needs to be pushed forward over here. Around, just follow the avenues. That's all I'm doing. It's just following the avenues of each neighborhood. And then as long as this is done, we'll wrap this episode up. I think that's a good way to come back since pretty much a whole week away. Well, not away because we've been streaming, so I apologize to you guys that require or are more based on YouTube to follow these videos. Hopefully, you guys, I'll try and give you guys a bit more love in the coming weeks as well. It's not going to be all just on Twitch. Okay, so that area is done, and now Velodrin, last neighborhood. We just got it zone up. And we'll remove all the zones from the avenues so that every zone is split up. There we go. Extend this out to here, this to here. There we go. And now the last thing. Just clear out these avenues like this. And this is essentially how I've been zoning all my neighborhoods. There we go. Finish this up. Finish. Oi, no. That didn't work out too well. Close that. Slow and steady. Slow and steady on these avenues. Slow and steady wins the day. Otherwise, you can always jump off and into the neighborhood and then you got to redo pretty much everything again, and that's not what I want to do. Okay, that's it. That's avenue done, and last avenue right here. Now, Kalima, policies, taxation everywhere. City planning, banning, Akina as well. Policies, high rise this, taxation for all four because it contains a bit of everything. Oshawa, as well. Do you have high density? No, you don't, so I won't do high density taxation, but I will do high rise ban and all that, just as a standard thing that we're doing. Felodrin as well. You have high density? No, you don't. So only low density taxing, high rise and heavy traffic ban. Okay, so that's it. That's all these neighborhoods done. Jump into camera mode. We should start seeing our income rise. So by the time when we come back for next episode, guys, we should have quite a more comfortable budget to work with. I mean, we've got a massive budget inside in for the city at the moment. It's over 4 million because we've been working slowly, progressing here and there, doing things nicely, and it's just built up over time as we've been constantly in the positives. And yeah, when we come back we should be getting definitely a lot more than 3,000 every week with these new taxation policies around these new neighborhoods that have pretty much got all the services that they require. So that's it, guys. I hope that you like this real big catch-up update episode. I apologize once again for not uploading. I've been, streaming on Twitch. If you guys by any chance want to watch any of the videos that have been on Twitch, you're more than welcome. The link's down below. It will take you directly to the channel. And From that channel, actually, you can watch all the videos that we did on all the farming work and all the little extra nits and bits of upgrading or just developing these suburbs. Also on the Facebook pages I may have mentioned, like that, if you want to stay in touch and see any future progress that's happening up or any progress of, say, new episodes coming up or when I'm uploading or when I'm rendering or future Twitch as well, streaming sessions that are going to be happening will all be up on that to let you guys know if you guys want to join in and participate. So for now, guys, thank you for watching, and I hope to release another video very, very soon for you. Okay? So for now, take care. Bye-bye.